Brutal clashes between the military and opposition protesters in Libya have now spread to the capital.
It's the strongest challenge in 40 years to the iron-fisted rule of Colonel Muammar Gaddafi, and his son is warning of all-out civil war. The demonstrators have seized control of large areas of the second city of Benghazi, where hundreds have been reported killed, and gunfire has been heard across Tripoli.
Defying the threat of further military crackdowns, protesters have filled the Libyan capital of Tripoli. They're demanding veteran leader Colonel Gaddafi relinquish a 41-year grip on power. State forces responded with live rounds and tear gas. Libya's second-largest city, Benghazi, has reportedly fallen to anti-government forces. As the army responds with fatal force, there are claims some in the military have joined the protests. Hospitals struggling with the rush of casualties.
All the hospitals are full, dead bodies. Even the fridges are full.
Reports the death toll has topped 250 have been denied by Gaddafi's son, who appeared on state-run television to quash rumours his father had fled Libya.
I heard more than 250 people were killed and more than 180 injured. This was an unbelievable exaggeration.
He branded the uprising a foreign plot, describing the country as teetering on the brink of civil war. As protests spread across the Middle East, disturbing images have emerged from the Gulf state of Bahrain. These YouTube images from 3 days ago showing protesters gunned down. The royal family has since ordered the army's withdrawal. In the past few hours, people have returned to Pearl Square and protest leaders are meeting to draw up a list of demands for Bahrain's ruling family. David Woywood, 10 News.